Computational thinking is the way of seeing the world that computer scientists have developed over the past, three, four, five decades. And it depends on seeing the world in terms of problems that can be solved algorithmically by specifying an effective process for solving them, basically a program.
This is James Larus, full professor and dean of the IC School at EPFL.
But it's not programming. It's basically a way of looking at a problem and saying, this is a hard problem or it's an easy problem. It's a problem that can be solved efficiently or it's a problem that can't be solved efficiently.
As computers are taking over the world, there is an increasing need for computational skills, both in the industry and in the academy. As a result, many universities have started educational programs to teach students to code. But the most important skill that computer scientists should teach may not be writing codes. In fact, a computer scientist is not necessarily a scientist that writes codes. Most of the computer scientists that we interviewed on Zettabytes actually barely write code at all. And personally, I haven't programmed for the last 2 or 3 years. Rather, the most important skill that computer scientists should be teaching might actually be computational thinking.
It's very important to distinguish the two. So computational thinking is the way in which you sort of think about the problems you want to solve. Programming is a technique for solving certain problems. Programming certainly requires computational thinking, but the fact that it can be applied in many different places is without programming is an argument for why it should be a widespread skill, that people should learn it in general, because it will help them in their sort of day-to-day life, even if they never program a computer.
Of course, the fact that we are more and more surrounded by computational devices is all the more a reason to teach and learn computational thinking.
As computers become even more embedded into our lives, people should really understand what they're capable of, what they're good at, that there are certain problems that you're just not going to end up with a good solution with a computer, no matter sort of how big the computer is, how fast the computer is. That, really people should be thinking about what they're trying to apply computers for in their life, in their job, in the things they're trying to build in the industry, and really sort of have an understanding rather than delegating this understanding to the programmers or the computer scientists that they hire to work with.
Particularly, it seems crucial for anyone who's directly or indirectly exploiting the capabilities of computers to better grasp their potential and their limits as well.
There are problems out there that we can show that there is just no way of solving them exactly every single time. There are other problems out there that we can come up with a good solution. We can prove that if you do it this way, you'll come up with the optimal, the best possible solution every single time. And then there are other problems out there that sort of are midway between. We know we can solve them, but we can't solve them efficiently. And so this way of dividing the world into categories, to problems we can solve, problems we can't solve, to be able to actually specify exactly what the steps are that you take to solve the problem, is really the heart of computational thinking. It's a way of seeing the world. It's a set of tools for understanding the world. It's a set of ways for interacting with the world that haven't really existed, that are quite different than the way other scientific or even other academic disciplines view problems in the world.
Perhaps the most important aspect of computational thinking is the ability to analyze everyday life problems, industrial problems, or academic problems from other fields in terms of computational concepts.
A good example that from Switzerland that I like to use is Swiss cheese is produced in these enormous round pieces of cheese. Nobody wants 20 or 30 kilos of cheese at once, and so it's sold in slices. And so, when they're produced, it has to be cut into slices. And so you get orders, and the orders may come in saying, I want 1 kilo or 3 kilos or 5 kilos of cheese. So you have this set of orders. You have these pieces of cheese that weigh certain things. So how do you cut the rounds into pieces so that you minimize the amount of waste? There's a simple algorithm, which is what most people would probably do, which is you take the biggest piece you want to cut, cut it first, and then you just keep cutting the biggest pieces until you can't find, you can't fit it anymore, and then you go to the next size down. And we can show that that's not a bad algorithm, that it's no worse than twice the optimal solution. But it's a very simple algorithm. It's very effective. You can use it easily. But to solve it precisely, to sort of come up with the absolute minimum amount of waste, it's what's called an NP-complete problem, which means that you have to examine all the possibilities, and there are an exponential number of possibilities. And so you can't solve it effectively in practice.
We talked about NP-completeness in a previous video with Professor Ola Svensson.
So this is a way in which you can actually take this computational thinking, apply it to problems in the real world, and sort of get what are practical solutions to these problems and understand how good these solutions are. The cheese cutting example is a good example. That doesn't involve programming. That's literally some guy with a big knife and pieces of cheese cutting it. And that, you know, is computational thinking.
So does this mean that computer science should be taught without programming?
No, I think computer science should be taught with programming, but I think that computer science should be taught as an intellectual discipline with some sort of very powerful ideas in it. And then you should be also taught programming as a way of applying these ideas in a very useful way. But you should understand that computer science is a lot more than just programming. It's, it's the techniques that we've developed, the way in which we analyze problems, the way in which we analyze solutions to problems that are extremely important in and of themselves. And even if you never program a computer, those are valuable for you.
My grand vision is that computational thinking will be a fundamental skill used by everyone by the middle of this century.
One of the big problems is that you have to find the teachers for it.